Welcome to Genius Connect. Please subscribe and share.
Hello friends, myself Manali at Jai International School. Today we are going to discuss about the periodic table. Right? What is this big word, periodic table? Right? It is related to the element. Right? What is element? We all are made up of matter, and matter is made up of element. So elements have to be placed at some place. And the place where all elements are kept, that is, we have given the space, right? In this universe, it is called as periodic table, right? Now, how the elements are arranged, whether they are arranged in columns, whether they are arranged in rows, how they are arranged, it is called as periodic table. So, there are many inventions based on periodic table. But the last periodic table that was accepted was the modern periodic table, right? And it is based on one law, right? What is that law, modern periodic law? It states that the properties of all elements are periodic function of their atomic number. What is the meaning of that? That elements are arranged according to their atomic number. Right? Because if we consider any other properties, that happens such that some elements have similar property. So if similar property, which elements we need to keep first and which element we need to keep last? Right? So it was a confusion. So then scientists identify the way to represent based on atomic number. Right? And we know that what is atomic number? The number of proton or electron. Right? So periodic table, it is a based on atomic number. Right? Now there are total 18 vertical columns called as groups in a periodic table. And there are total 7 horizontal rows called as period. Right? So 18 groups and 7 period consist of a periodic table. Now, each group has their own characteristics. Each period has their own characteristics, right? So, periodic, because based on this periodic table, all elements are combining with other elements to give us n number of molecules, right? So, how the properties are remembered? So, if we'll see on the left hand side of the periodic table, right, they have the positive charge. What is that positive charge? I mean, they have ability to donate electron to someone, right? Now, why they are donating electron? So, elements wants to give electron because to get stabilized. That means they want to get stability. Now, stability means what? So, if they have 8 electrons in their outermost shell, right? Then any element is said to be a stable. So, if I want to be a stable, I want to give either electron or either I want to accept electron. Now, it is based on me. For example, if I am any element, right? I want to be stable. Then it is totally on me that how I can give proton or electron, whether I have to accept electron. Now, for example, if I will say that I am sodium, right? I keep myself as a sodium. That means then I have to think, what is my atomic number? Okay, I guess my atomic number is 11. So that means if I will write in the form of electronic configuration, right, in the cell, then I can write it is like that 281. Right? It is based on the rule 281. That means in my last cell only one electron is there. So if I want to get stabilized, then what I want to do? Either I have to give my last electron to someone, or either I have to accept other 7 electrons, right? So that means then only I can get stable. So which will be easy? It will be easy to give one electron because one electron is present in mass. But if I will accept 7, it will be difficult for me. So that is why it is totally on me that whether I have to give or whether I have to accept. Right? So that is what all periodic table elements suggest. Thank you.
I hope you all would have enjoyed this video. Subscribe to Genius Connect and put on the notification to receive more such videos. Like and share this video too. Thanks for watching.